Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in the Curious Expedition. So, it didn't go so well last time. That's kind of becoming a habit of mine, isn't it? So, what are we gonna try next? We have tried with Richard Francis Burton, Marie Curie, Charles Darwin, and Alessandra David Neal. Have we tried any of the others? I don't remember. Didn't we try... No, I'm not sure if we tried Amelia Earhart. Maybe we should just try the next one here. Johann Huizinga, anthropologist and one of the founders of modern cultural history. Anthropological studies of indigenous cultures that can be created for additional fame. Interesting. So that would give us an artist again, a Persian translator, a donkey, and get like a pistol and some canvases, of course, for our painter. A little bit of whiskey. Well, let's give it a go and see if how it's gonna go. Okay. 6 expeditions coming up. So, well. I'm still failing completely at this, so we're gonna have to stick with tourist trip. Okay, Valley of Jungle and Strange Drylands. I feel like we have been to both of these before. But we had the jungle last time, so let's go for the Strange Drylands. Early that morning, I arrived at the docks. We had a little time before the ship would be ready, so I spent my time on the deck, enjoying the cool breeze. A trader walked up to me and pleaded for my help. He needed a message to be delivered to the chief of a village that we should surely stumble upon during our trek. Okay, I'll go for that. He handed us a sealed envelope, which I promised to deliver. Okay, so off we go. On more adventures. So let's see what's gonna happen this time. Oh, if we can actually survive this. I was finishing up my morning ablutions as one of the crew called Lan Ahoy, the foreign landscape beckoned us to explore. Let's see. Of course, we have the leather, we have the pistol, we have some shovels, which is probably always handy. So, yeah. I think that's fine. And... Oh, it's drylands, but we don't need... Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's only for the desert. It might be favorable to deliver the letter first. Thankfully, the man had pinpointed the location of the village on our map. Oh, that's handy. Okay, so down there somewhere. What is this? Hills. Okay, well, and this one? Inactive volcano. Oh wow. I have a feeling we're gonna have problems with lava in this one. Ooh, what are you? A shrine? Oh, let's go down here. Get that up. Examine shrine. A temple long forgotten by mankind stood bathed in light before us. Its stone walls were covered with ornate engravings. Grand stairs led up to an enormous doorway. I could swear I heard the sound of rushing water under our very feet. You're one weird person. Yes, they usually are. Oh, we can even paint. Let's paint it first. Antoine Montagnier? Agreed to capture the essence of the wonderful sight on canvas and enthusiastically started to paint the shrine. A few hours later, his work was done, which we carefully secured in a crate. Okay. We carefully entered a well-preserved ceremonial chamber. We quietly looked around the majestic hall. We found a stone altar that was covered in ancient writings. Okay. Necronomicon, an old heavy leather-bound book with metal clasps by author Abdul al-Hasrat. A sinister feeling seems to radiate from the book, and a golden amulet. Well, this one is pretty. There's a lot of fame from that one. This one, apparently we can only sell this one. Okay, well, I'm gonna steal it. What a glorious day. The treasure was to be mine. I grabbed what we could and hurried outside as enormous fountains of water burst through the ground and began to flood the surrounding area. We had to run like our lives depended on upon it or drown in the grand lake forming around us. Oh yeah. Can we go above here or do we have to go around? Look at all that water. Never good. Oh, there's all this stuff. Okay, where is this pointing? Ah, somewhere over here looks. Let's get some of this whiskey, which is the only thing we have to eat so far. Oh, look at the water. It's always catching up with us. Better let it get going. Oh, wow. That is moving fast. This evening we reached the village. The villagers demanded respect because they were a group of skilled scouts. As we arrived, the village was buzzing with activity, but no one really paid attention to us. We moved freely about the village and considered our options with these people. The villagers had been awaiting us. They already seemed aware of us. They were cautious but politely offered their help, perhaps to see us leave sooner. Upon our arrival, Yeganei Taupor began to converse with the natives. Well, we need to deliver the letter. We brought the letter to the village chief. To reward us, the chief regaled us with stories of the greatest wonders to look upon in the vicinity, including a holy shrine, which he marked on our map. Okay, that's gonna be interesting if it's the one we just defiled. Our extended presence was perceived well by the natives. They remained kind and we felt like special guests in the settlement. Let's see if they have anything. Well, they do have some berries, which would be handy. Red mushroom. Healing abilities, mini puppets, drums. Native trinkets, jewels, water, and elephant tusk. Okay, do we have anything? Okay, it doesn't have any value to trade this with them now. What if we give them a couple of shovels and a torch? Maybe that's not gonna help much. Alien collection. I really don't want to split with this though. Okay, we only have one shovel then. At least we have a little bit. Food. And yeah, let's just rest. As darkness fell, the natives lit a campfire and invited us to sit with them. The natives shared their food with us and we spent an enjoyable evening with them. Kind of interesting with the clothes he's traveling in. Overburden. Yeah, okay. And anthropology. How do we do this with the... Oh, that's right. Okay, study culture. Let's do that. I spent more time this evening on an anthropological analysis. With the natives' consent, I spent a few hours cataloging their clothing. Interesting. Okay, and then we can pay the native. We inquired if anyone was willing to have a portrait created of their likeness. We found a volunteer, so Antoine Montagnier did not want to miss the unique chance to create a portrait of the native woman. I slept in great comfort and safety. The following morning I awoke to the laughter of the natives. Although we were by no means unwelcome, I sensed that the natives were somewhat unsettled by our manner. Okay. Can we recruit anyone? I sat down and spoke with the natives to see if some of them were willing to join my cause. However, all of the villagers refused to join the trek. We seemed to have gained a bad reputation amongst these people. Despite the intriguing interaction, I could tell that the natives were on edge. Yeah, we're gonna leave. I told the men to pack up and headed out as new adventures could be waiting over the next ridge. And we're almost driving. Well, there's something up here, so let's go up there and see what that is, if we can. Oh, it's... This water has spread all over. Oh, this is gonna be problematic. Enter stone circle. Oh, that's... I don't think we've seen one of these before, have we? Interesting. I love how you always find new stuff. At least I don't believe... I don't remember seeing one of these before. There's so many different possibilities of what you might find. We came across a stone circle that was obviously man-made. There were inscriptions painted upon each rock. Perhaps they formed a kind of map? Oh, nice. Reveal camp points. Or reveal caves. Well, camp points might be a good idea. Since we're gonna be a little... have a little bit of a problem. Okay, so there's a camp or something over there. Oh, right, it's the first expedition, so it's always a small map. Well, let's eat this. And what do we have? I don't really have anything we can use for anything. So, we're so gonna be... things are so gonna go bad. For us, because we are out of everything. Yeah. This journey was taking its toll on everyone. At night I heard an angry curse. Antoine Monchenier had been bitten and was bleeding from an unsightly leg wound. He was screaming at me to take the appropriate measures against the animal responsible. It was obvious that Sir Bakra was the attacker, as he was trying to hide behind a large rock. I could see the panic in his eyes. No, I don't want to butcher the donkey. I refused to punish the animal, which upset Antoine Montagnier beyond a civilized measure. He would need a while to accept my decision. Okay. Ugh, that's gonna be so hard. Okay, at least we got there without any problems. So, explore. We approached an old campsite. There were debris of what seemed to be a failed expedition that must have been here for a long time. The rotten remains of what must have been a French explorer gazed at us through split eyes of it. On the upside, one competitor less. This area was marked heavily by animal tracks. I had to keep moving or end as someone's dinner. Oh, we're gonna search the area anyway. I was certain there were riches to be found here. I instructed the people to form small teams and investigate the surroundings. Oh, yay! Look at that, we got some mangoes. As we left, we became aware that our presence had attracted ferocious wildlife. Yep. Okay. There we go. So, let's head over here. We can outrun these hyenas. What now? Without access to medical equipment, it was nearly impossible to prevent an injury from becoming infected. Antoine Montagnier's wound was beginning to look particularly nauseating. That's not so good. Explore. We arrived at a rock overhang. It would serve as a basic shelter against the elements. Okay, I was hoping it would be a different type of... I could actually probably have checked it on the map. Well, let's paint the landscape. I can't be asking Antoine Montagnier to create a painting. However, he was incensed by my request. Perturbed by my instruction, he jammed the brush in my pocket and insisted I paint it, while cursing our expedition at the top of his lungs. Wow. Okay. Well, let's rest so we can get a little bit of sanity, hopefully. I instructed the trick to hold and I told the people to rest. One could cut the tension with a butter knife as we sat and stared into the fire. Times were dark and Yegani Talpoa was my only human help. It was just a matter of spending enough time together until we got into a pointless argument. I don't exactly recall how it started, but it involved a vitriolic account about the similarities between the colonies and my goons. We did not speak for the rest of the day. Oh, wow. Okay. Well, that happens when people are tired and exhausted and stuff. We prepared for departure. Despite the looming rock, it had been a pleasant pitch. Okay, I'm gonna leave. And okay, we seem to have to go up this way to somewhere to find our pyramid. So let's head Okay, nothing. Well, we don't have anything to eat, so we just have to move. Yep, look at that. This expedition was taking its toll on all of us. At night I heard an angry curse. Antoine Montagnier had been bitten and was bleeding from an unsightly torso wound. He was screaming at me to take the appropriate measures against the animal responsible. It was obvious that Sir Racha was the attacker as he was trying to hide behind a large rock. I could see flesh caught between its teeth. Oh, he bit him even harder this time. Refuse. Yeah, he's not gonna be happy about me refusing that, but we're almost home, so explore. Ooh, the Pyramid of Gold beckoned us to victory, outwitting all trials before us we had succeeded. Ooh, that was close. After such an endeavor, tremendous relief overcame me. I knew that this name, Johann Huizinga, would be written about long after I departed this life. Very nice. Golden Pyramid. New World bonus, nice. Big bonus. I'm still trying to figure this out. I really ought to go back. I think I said this a little while back that I really ought to check all these, but I'm pretty sure we've been to this map before, because I really don't get this new world bonus, what it means. Because I thought it meant that whenever you explored a new map or completed a new map, you would get this, but I'm not sure. And we made it number some as the first one. A new expedition, nice. Okay, what do we have? Wound treatment, that's always good. Lutician, explosion expert, and eagle eye. Well, I think we want the wound treatment, that is always handy to have. See how it's going for the other ones. Well, it looks like we should be able to pass him, so let's see. Value 20, fainting. Well, let's just... Oh, let's see. Value 50, fame 70. Value 10. Yeah, let's gift this one. Let's gift this one. And sell this one. There we go. Okay, so we are in first place now. Nice. Then we'll see you in the next expedition. We're gonna pick between the Arctic and the desert. Very interesting. Anyway, thank you for watching, and please do leave a like and a comment. So take care, everyone, and happy gaming.